Hello everyone, Gumball here, and welcome to Terraria 1.3, where today me and Lucy are going to be taking on the Lunar event from start to finish, which will probably be a few episodes. Don't know how long this is going to take, we're not the biggest pros ever. But we're going to start after you have defeated the boss Golem. These lunatics will come here, and they'll be worshipping this mysterious tablet, so you'll have to take them out. So we're just gonna do that, and that should be pretty easy. And then now we have spawned the lunatic cultist, and that's who we want to defeat at the moment. So I don't know the attack pattern of this boss. All I know is that he's causing a lot of pain. I want to switch to my crimson knives. Him. Just get my health up. He seems to have a sort of teleport, a form of cloning himself. I think you can't take out the clones. And he also has some sort of fireball. So that should be alright to deal with, though. We're getting there. There's the real one. And I think I'll leave the gear we're using in the description, if I remember. And this is in expert mode, so much harder, but we are at two players, so that also means that the boss has a larger health counter than you would usually, but we still have an advantage. There we go. The cultist was defeated. Did we really get anything from that? No. Let me mark that before I accidentally end up defeating it. Not really much there. Okay, so that should cause... it says celestial creatures are invading. Does that have much of an effect on the map? Oh, yeah, here we go. We found there's the pillars around the world. So we have the nebula pillar, the solar pillar, the stardust pillar, and the vortex pillar. So I think it's the vortex pillar first. So just head over this way. We'll have to fly across, so I'll we'll go over there, and then we'll start recording again when we make it. So be right back. So guys, we're back, and we've reached the first pillar, and I think I need to turn off this background, because it's very laggy for me. Oh, it is off. Oh my gosh. Shouldn't be this laggy. I'm going to switch to my knives, if it will let me. There we go. Oh. And we have a load of new mobs here, so we have... some form of dragon. For some reason my flight got stuck. We have nothing that I can quite see. I'm actually going to teleport over to Luffy at the moment, just to make it here. And there should be a pillar around here. I don't know if we have to take out all the mobs first. Oh, here's the pillar. I think we have to take out everything around here first, though. So these seem to be some form of alien queen that I can't do anything against. Well, that failed. They're pretty strong. I think they have a form of ranged attack, and my knives are no match for them. Are the abilities of my knives not working? I don't think they are. What's this effect? Distorted. Gravity around you is distorted. Oh. Oh, this is kind of cool. So there's a form of gravity effect. I do seem to be getting my health. Alien lava, they're called. I'm not sure how we attack the pillar. if at all. Do they seem to be coming from a particular source? They just come from the pillar. Okay. So each of these mobs is coming from the pillar. Oh my gosh. Something like that. Oh, you're invisible. That's very difficult. So that was the vortex pillar. Let's just head to the Stardust pillar since that's right here. So it's not far away. It's definitely more difficult than I expected, especially after the last boss we just went against. Here we go. Yeah, these backgrounds definitely cause a bit of frame loss. This seems like an easier area. I don't know. Still a lot of damage around here. I really want to get the dust from this pillar for the cool armor it has. I'm still not quite sure how we get through this though. I think it might be like the other events where you have to take out such and such an amount before you can get anything done. That's a good few of them. We've be about 26. I don't know how many Luffy's be. 30. Probably have to go somewhere near 100. I do seem to be dealing damage to it, actually. It doesn't have a health bar, but it does seem to take damage. So maybe we are meant to be able to destroy it. It is healing me, definitely, so that gives me the kind of feeling that is the case. Try to use my hatchet. Hit multiple targets. It does say I'm dealing large amounts of damage, but only on occasion, so I'm not sure it's actually working. Oh, that's you. You have armor that matches theirs. Well, no. That's the color of the screen. Yeah, I don't seem to be able to hit this. There must be some way. I don't know if it's an ability only, or if it's defeat such and such an amount. This is certainly easier than the vortex pillar, though, to survive. That's 100 for me. Oh, that's 100 for both of us. Can we hit it yet? No. Oh, my health. Yep. I think we should search up what we're doing first. That'd probably be a good idea. We're currently in version 1.3.0.3, with the latest being 0.0.5, so we can't get any of the newest stuff from the bosses and stuff, but we've got some pretty cool loot here. I And I think with expert mode... Oh, here we go. We've broken through. So we beat 145 of them when it opened up. I don't know. It must be after you defeat a certain amount. Almost beat the pillar. There we go. Pillar defeated. And here's all the Stardust fragments. This is for the melee-based armor. I think we should actually check the guide. And see what we can make out of these. And then we can move on to the next pillar. So guys, I'm back, and it's time to see what we can make with the Stardust fragments. So we can make the Super Healing Potion, which is which does require the other fragments, the Vortex, Solar, and Nebula. There's also the Stardust Fragment Block, the Lunar Hook, which is each of the fragments. That looks like a four-use hook. We have the Solar Fragment, which is, I believe, the fragment that's used to make the ingot for the armor. The Vortex Fragment and the Nebula Fragment. We have the Monolith, which changes the background of the area where you have it activated. And we... Oh no, so it's not for the armor. You use the Fragments plus Luminite Bars to make the Stardust Armor, which is... Luminite Bars I think you get from the boss. Then you've got the Pickaxe, the Hamaxe, the Cell Staff, and the Dragon Staff. And the Wings. So one thing we really want to make is the Dragon Staff. You have 8 more, right, Luffy? That I can borrow? Oh, thank you. Oh, a superior one. Now, if you continuously use this, it's meant to make the dragon get longer. Maybe it's in a newer version. But we have a super cool, much stronger... minion now that does a lot of damage. So next I think we should move on to the solar pillar. So we'll head on over to the solar pillar and come right back. So guys, we're back at the solar pillar where I just instantly died. These backgrounds cause a few problems, but let's see how much harder the solar pillar is. We have strollers, which seem like a form of meteor. We have some other stuff that I can't quite get the name of because it moves so fast. And we should be able to just use our knives from the air for this one, I'm hoping. We have a very paladin-looking test. Oh my gosh. I can't even hit that thing. Can you actually hit the cruel tipede? Does that thing actually have a health bar? Oh, okay. Not another one. Why do you only have the normal minecart? You need a better minecart. Oh, come on. We can do this. Or not. Instantly. Oh my gosh. I think it's roughly 150 that you beat before you can go against the boss one. And just like most events, it doesn't matter if you die because you can just come back. So we're taking on just as many dudes as we can, really. Seems like the safest strategy. Gosh, those guys. We're using the T-Shock server console to do the teleportation stuff. Just makes it much easier to get to places. Oh my gosh. Ah. Oh. Whoops. There's no way I could regen health fast enough just to take them on. Unlike the other section, it's not really obvious as to how many we've beat because it's so many different types of mob. I've got 8, 6, plus 8. Not many. Ugh. Luffy should really have used the chain gun. Let's take out these, what are they called, Korites? And die to a cruel torpedo again, and again. It's 20 plus 6 plus 8. 22 plus 6 plus 8 get us at 36. We've beat roughly 40. It's 7 quarter beats. Yeah, just over 40. Which isn't as good as last time. Oh my gosh. You know what we should do? I should totally add a death counter into the video. No comment. I don't even have any coins to lose anymore. And I had stacks upon stacks of 999 platinum, so that's kinda annoying. Luckily this one isn't far away. Oh yeah, I wasn't really using my dragon staff. Did you notice I cleaned everything up around the base? Yeah. I had a lot of gravestones everywhere. I don't know how this works, if it's like when you die it resets the counter or not. Hopefully not. Oh. Oh, you've got that now. Is it a rapid one? You just have normal musket balls? No. What are you using then? I didn't get that at all. Okay, there's another cruel torpedo that's really getting on my nerves. Ugh, why do they have to be so flexible? That's 30. Yay! No! Oh, got one. I think focusing on the dudes on the ground doesn't really work. Well. If one of us maybe tries distracting the cruel speeds and the other one just focuses on the guys on the ground. Or not. That's not really gonna work. Go away. Or not. Which one, the tsunami's better? Let me use my Kraken. That doesn't work either. Kraken plus yo-yo pouch equals nothing. Oh well. I know the bosses and things are generally harder than the normal guys, but I don't see how anything much could be harder than this, unless it was impossible. Why did we have to pick expert mode? We should have done this in normal mode first, and got all the good gear. But no, we're crazy. Got him! I'm just waiting for that shield to get off, and then we'll be fine, I hope. We must be getting there. Come on. We got 59 of the chlorites, 17 of something else. 6 for 17 is 70 something in total. We've at least reached the 80s. No, 100s. Heal up, use my dragon staff, get hit by a meteor. And die. That is the process. Oh, did we use my thing? Nope, that's not gonna heal you. No matter how many life fruits you can shoot. No, wrong command. Don't want to use that command. Pun? Ah. Are you sure? So you're saying that the flaming part right at the end that looks weak is probably the weak point. That does make sense. I'm assuming his head is not the weak point. Logically, you would think shooting up the mouth of a giant centipede would help kill it, but apparently not. Ugh. I don't know if the thing's... No, thing's not breaking yet. I don't know, maybe I did do enough damage to the shield, and maybe it's not from defeating enough minions. But this is an event, so I would assume that since it didn't show any damage counter on the shield. Nope, I should be aiming for the rump of the centipede. Oh, that's an idea. Just use a pigmon mount, that works. Or not. You just get a bleh. We should totally have TeamSpeak on. I don't know why we don't have TeamSpeak on. See, this is when Luffy actually knows what to say, when we're not on TeamSpeak. That stupid thing, you can never get to the weak point. Oh, yes, going! It must be after the mobs then. Dealing damage, it's almost done, it's so close! This is probably going to be one video. Yeah, done. We did it. Get all the loot. Oh. Let's get... What? Why are you here? You shouldn't be here. I thought I was free. Why? It makes sense. They're not in their home environment. They still do enough damage. Yeah, you're right. The Crawlipede's weak point is the tail. That's correct. We need to get the solar fragments. I think that's all the ones that came over here. So you can minecart over on our mechanical cart. I think the whole expert mode reward back thing is really cool. Bye bye. Slow coach. All the fragments. And a lot of coins, yeah. Maybe I'll find all of that lost platinum. Almost doubt it, it's probably all at... Well, actually, no, I didn't die. It's probably all at that first boss. But yeah, should we see if there's anything different you craft with this stuff? Before heading on to the next boss. Let's see where... There's the guide. We will head on to the next core. Let's see, solar fragments. So, we have the potions once more, the blocks once more, the lunar hook once more. We then have armor. This is another melee armor. This is a tank one. You have increased movement speed and melee damage, and enemies are more likely to target you. I don't know what the set bonus is. We also have the solar eruption, which is a flail, which I might get, and Daybreak, which is actually, as far as I can tell, a really good spear that I'm going to make right now. The Daybreak. 223. Because I don't have damage boosting things on anymore, I've got crit strike. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the Daybreak. I think that will replace my Scourge quite well. And... Oh my gosh! This isn't just a spear. No, it's a melee weapon, though. I don't know... If it's like this, where it's really good, then yeah, I'll have it. That's the only time I would have it, really. Oh, Zealous Solar Eruption. Let's see if this... It does more damage than the Flareon, even though it's not a godly one. I'll have to... upgrade these ones. Oh my gosh, it's like a weird sword. How much damage? Oh my gosh! Look at the damage count! Let's try the spear. Yeah, I really like these. Okay, so we're going now to go to the next section, take on the next boss, and we'll be right back. So guys, we're back at the next section, where... Oh my gosh, this is really pink. Purple. Whatever. Both. We... Oh my gosh. I've got a need for health. Oh my gosh. A brain suckler. That is one weird name. Everything here seems to be based around... Confusion? What was that? Luckily we have an Ankh shield, so that should prevent any status effects. That's 8 floaters. I have one of those items. The new 1.3 items. The tally counter. Well, it's not a sucker, it's a suckler.
It's the same thing!
No, it's not the same thing. That's 50. Oh, I'm trying to attack you! All the time! I think the vortex. I think the one that we decided to go for first, the vortex one, happened just to be the hardest one. The solar one was pretty hard, but at least we could beat it. Oh my gosh. I keep running out of health. We can last quite a while here. This is probably the second easiest after the blue one. An evolution beast. It's a weird name for a beast. What does it do? Luckily it's nighttime, so I have my melee boosts from my werewolf form. I also do have a swimming form. Why aren't any of these near the water? Then I could just swim out the way and just be like, hello. Oh, that's something I found out about Fishrun, actually, that I forgot to tell you. We only took on Fishrun yesterday, was it? Yeah, just yesterday. But, we did not realize that Fishrun gets enraged when you're out of the water. So that's probably why he was, like, much better than we expected. He was probably just strengthened by, my whisper's gone green. Gosh, this is weird. Okay, the thing should be opening soon. We've reached 100 and whatever. It looks like it's getting somewhere. It has a weird animation at the top. I think, there we go. I think after it spawns a certain amount. Oh my gosh, these are so easy, these pillars. Okay, there we go. That's the pillars. I just got one more left. I've got to redo that last one. Oh! Give me the hearts. All the hearts. So now we'll have a look at what we can do with the nebula fragments. And then we'll take on the vortex pillar. And hopefully be moving on to the boss. So let's go home. Did I get any of them? Do you have all of the fragments? Can you just pass me it just one so I can see, show everyone what we can do? Thank you. Let's head on down to the guide. And what can we do? Now, I think the nebula is more of a magic-based one, judging by the whole confusion effect thing. So we have the armor, which is magic-based, yeah. Pickaxe and stuff. We have the Nebula Arcanum, which is a magic weapon, and we have the Nebula Blaze, which is also a magic weapon, so we're not going to be getting either of those, since Luffy's going Ranger and I'm going Melee. We might get them in the future, though. I'm interested in trying a mage setup, so that'd be kind of cool. So now we just need to take out the, that's weird. Oh! Okay, I'll probably showcase some of this stuff afterwards in more detail, I don't know. But let's head on over to the vortex area, which is coming up right here. It's a good distance away, but we can pigrun mount it, I'm sure. Oh my gosh, this pigrun is slow. let's cut here, and we'll be right back. So guys, we're back in the vortex area where we're probably going to die horribly many times. We'll try Pigron mounting it, since even though they can fly, we can take them out in bunches, hopefully, without instantly dying. We have actually beat quite a lot of them, so we might have got quite close last time to breaking through the thing. The whole gravity thing can be avoided by staying high enough on a mount, I guess. Not quite sure. We have a few effects. We have Beetle Might, that's from my armor. We have a dragon. Yeah, we don't seem to be getting the whole gravity thing. So if we just stay high enough, I think we can avoid it. Where's the thing? I don't even know where the pillar thing is. Oh, here it is. So we've reached over 200. Gosh. It must be because these have low health. Yeah, that's 250. We seem to be breaking through. It's vibrating a lot. Well, not vibrating, what's it? Pulsating. That's the word. Oh, I died. I died to alien goop, apparently. Otherworldly voices linger around us, according to earlier text that I didn't bother reading, apparently. I was probably dying. We have destroyed a lot of them. I think it's a whole wave system. Yeah, definitely. So what happens is you kill all of them, the thing will summon more, and after a while, it can't summon anymore, and has to get rid of its shield. Maybe it's putting out its life force to defend itself in the form of these. This is just an interesting way of thinking of it. Almost like a lore thing. It might be putting out its life force as these minions trying to defend itself, and what we're doing is killing off by destroying these minions that would otherwise return to it and give it all its life back. That's how I'm going to assume it is, anyway. It just sounds cool. Yeah, we're reaching the 400s. There we go. Gosh. Is this a 500 one or more? Oh, there we go. I guess it was 500 then. There we go. We take this out so quickly. That is the Vortex Pillar. Defeated. So there's the Vortex Fragments. We can craft quite a few things now. We're just lacking the Luminite Ingots. That's a whole load of hearts. There we go, that's the Vortex Fragment. And everything has gone really weird. That must be the Moon Lord. Where could he possibly be? I'm not seeing him on the map, but everything's going weird. I don't know if it's a slow process. Yeah, it just continues doing this to me. Dropping my frames. Like, I am recording. Show some consideration. We earned the Star Destroyer achievement, and it says impending doom approaches. I really want to talk to the crafting guide. Oh my gosh. He's here. Oh my gosh. Okay, now if I remember correctly, we have to take out the eye areas. So, yeah, it's his hands and then his face. There's an eye at the top of his head that you'll also have to take out. I want to dodge that. Gosh, this guy is hard to aim at. All of the eyes. I don't know, a weird way of grabbing people. There we go. My meat was ripped off by a phantasmal bolt. I think we've lost. I guess we'll just have to redo it. We can update to get the... We can update to make the celestial stone. Or we can just cheat it in for the purposes of the video. This is expert mode. I don't know how we're going to beat this. Wait, what? The vortex ones? For the purposes of the grappling hook. The solar fragment. The armor is ranged, but you can't make it. What? Oh, the weapons. You need the Vortex Beta and the Phantasm, which you can finally get. That's 18 plus 18. How many do you have? How many do you have? Because there might be... You have 4. You're probably lying to me. But here you go. No, I want to craft some stuff too. Now I should have enough fragments to make... Oh, you can transform all the other fragments into one of another. That's, as far as I can tell, an incredibly bad idea. What fragment am I can you please pass me some more nebula fragments? Thank you. So, now we can make the lunar hook. Let's try out the lunar hook. So we'll equip this, and we might even just do the main boss as a separate video. Yeah, this is like a 4 grappling hook. Are you enjoying your new weapons? Oh my gosh, that's ridiculous. But yeah, these are the new weapons. I might go more in detail over them in a separate video. I think that might be the end of this video. So that is how to reach the Moon Lord. Do we want to continue this video, Luffy? Or do we want to do a separate one? I think we'll continue it. That sounds like a good idea. We're probably going to die miserably. But that's alright with me. What are you looking for? So, we could also, if you ever at any point want to, try different class setups. You said you got the Nebula Arcanum, right? That's the one you showed? Or the Blaze. Okay, I'll get the Arcanum just to show what it looks like. So this is the Nebula Arcanum. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. But I've ran out of mana because, yeah, I'm not running a mage setup right now. I might do that at some point. But I think what me and Luffy will, I think what we should actually do now is we're going to upgrade our new weapons and then see if we can summon the Moon Lord. So we'll be back in a minute. So guys, we're back, and we've upgraded our weaponry to the best, so I've got my Godly Daybreak and Godly Solar Eruption, though I'd probably stick with the knives. Not looked up a guide or anything, because we're probably stupid, and this is, we're in expert mode, so we're probably going to die instantly because we don't have the newer armor. When you beat the boss, he'll drop the Luminite ingots, so I recommend possibly trying to beat him first in normal mode. We're probably going to die terribly right now. But we're going to spawn in the Moon Lord with the T-Shot command. And he's an invalid boss type. Boss Moon. What? Dash spawn mob Moon. Oh. Moon Lord. Oh, so we can't just spawn in the Moon Lord. Are you sure? We are going to have to update to Terraria 1.3.0.5. Be back soon due to technical issues. So guys, we're back for the second round against the Moon Lord. And I'm actually going to use the heal command at this point. Because regening too slow. I just want to see if we can legit full health take him on at least. Luffy is not here yet. Oh, he's here. That was bad timing. Okay, now that he has his OP... Now that you can actually use your OP stuff, you have to go for the eye that appears on the head and the two hands. Did the music just cut off? It just cut off. It didn't do that last time, did it? Okay, I'm just going for his eye. Trying to vampire knife it. It's not giving me much stuff back. Gosh, this isn't a very good method. I'm just kind of shooting everywhere I possibly can. How do you dodge that? How do you dodge that? Please stay alive until I respawn. One thing that's really annoying with expert mode is that in even outside of multiplayer, respawn times are are at, like, there's an extra 30. Yeah, there's an extra 30 seconds on the respawn. Is he actually coming for me though? Oh my gosh, it's so dark. I can't see anything. We seem to have beat the first something seconds dead. Oh, I'm alive! It didn't kill me!
I'm barely alive!
I shouldn't be alive. I'm dead. I shouldn't be alive, he says. Oh my gosh. We might have to go into our 1.2 world. Okay. I think... I don't know if this will work. Oh, I just had an amazing idea. Oh, it's not going to work, though. Dang it. I was hoping he wouldn't be able to kill me if I was inside the house. I was hoping I could do what you can do with the Martian sources. Oh, gosh. This has probably got to be really dark on YouTube. I don't even know where you are. There you are. I'm going to bring out my Stardust Dragon. I'm going to... Oh, it's actually quite easy to dodge that laser, he says, before crashing into it. It's quite easy to dodge it if you are on a mount. You just go round in the same circle it's going in. We've almost taken one hand out. That's a good sign. We've almost taken one hand out. Did we lose? Okay. What? A giant blue blast just landed on my head. After we've been defeated. Okay, what do we do now then? We just defeated the event a second time. I think it's best to just update to 1.3.0.5, do you think? So welcome back. We'll go update our game and see if we can defeat the Moon Lord, at least try, because I think if I try and spawn him in, spawn boss, whoops, if I go the dash spawn boss command and say moon, dash spawn boss, oh my gosh, sorry, spawn boss, moon, let's just, oh yeah, okay, let's try Moon Lord, because that's his name, so we'll go Moon Lord. It's an invalid boss type, oh, must be mob. This is interesting. Moon, there we go. See, it's only the head, hand, core, and leech clot that you can summon. If I try the core, then we can see, Moon Lord. We defeated the 100 birds. Let's see. Oh yeah, there it is. Okay, we can do it again, because we're smart like that. You have to kind of aim ahead of these. That's the hard part. Can't really aim directly at them. Gosh, keeping ahead of that laser beam is difficult. I managed it, though. Not because I'm a pro, just because I was lucky. That's honestly all I can say it was. If I was a pro, we wouldn't have lost, like, a million times. Let me go!
Where are you?
I'm about to not be up here. We almost took out one of the hands last time. This time, we don't seem to be doing so well. Oh, went right into the blast. Oh, come on. We can do this. We can do this. Let's make sure we're on full health when we start this. Is there anything you're not doing right, do you think? Oh, we're using your bow. The gun's worse than the bow. That thing there is worse. What, is it a dual weapon? So, is it now better? Okay, we'll try again. This boss is impossible. I'm kind of debating whether to go for damage or health. Like, right now I'm going the damage route. Let's see how that turns out. Okay, I'm gonna heal. Use these to try and get some health back. I think a mix of damage and healing is the best option. I'm just focusing on this, just this one. Ugh, that didn't work. 20, 19, okay. That was better than I expected. Oh, did you die? Oh, it's all the way up there. Hey, now you die. There he is. Okay. Oh my gosh. Oh. I managed to grab no health there. Survive. Your main goal now is just to dodge. Just dodge. Okay, I'm fine. Oops. That's just where I happen to be. We have overlapping music. Where are you? I'm gonna die. I survived. You were phantasmal feared. Feared. Almost said smeared. There he is. Not good. We've almost defeated one hand. You use the map when you can't find people. Don't TP. Not there. Not when I die. Oh, I survived. Yeah, I mean, I appeared instantly. Are you sure? Oh my gosh. What do we do? I think we've run out of time for this episode. Definitely. So, that episode ends in we suck, apparently. I think the goal now is just to, either get better gear, I'm not really sure about updating since we can still get the guy, or try it in normal first, and then come back here. Do you want to do that? To get the armor and stuff. Do you want to record it in normal? Just normal? You just want to do it in expert. Okay. So, that's the end of this episode of Terraria 1.3 Lunar Event. If you enjoyed this episode, please leave a thumbs up, even though we failed miserably. hopefully you got a good look at what is available in the event, if you haven't seen it already. And we will see you next time, when hopefully we'll... We will beat the Moon Lord. Bye-bye.